This past Mother's Day weekend, Mr. and Mrs. Manoj and Geeta Singh of Caesar Productions held DC South 2013. This was an elegant and a beautiful affair. In fact, all the feature films, as well as documentary, the stars, the producers, and their styles, you know, these have all become the talk of the town. The one star where many had interactions with and admired was Mr. Farooq Sheikh. He is an awesome actor as well as a charming personality. Let's share his charm with you on our screen of Chitramala. Namaskar, adab. Mere saath aaj star of Mr. Umrao Jaan, Mr. Chashme Bhadur, aur phir kal yahan DC Saif, Mr. Manoj Singh and Ms. Geeta Singh ne yahan pe jo movie dikhlai, unka naam Listen Amaya, the star of all stars, Mr. Farooq Sheikh. Namaskar ji.
Namaskar. Kaise
aap ji?
Bahut adab.
Adab. Aap hamesha prim and proper in white kurti lagte hain. Always my compliments off to you.
Oh, thank you.
I saw your movie last night.
Okay.
I was totally impressed. It was beautiful. Congratulations. Tell me your experience.
I had not met Mr. Avinash Singh and his wife, Ms. Geeta Singh, before they approached me with the script.
Right.
So I read the script and I thought it was a very good idea.
Mm-hmm.
And then I spoke with them at length to understand whether they are the kind of people who would intend to deliver what the script said,
sure,
which they turned out to be.
Mm-hmm.
And since they are first-time filmmakers,
mm-hmm,
and interestingly first-time writer, producer, editor, director,
that's
combination,
right.
So I knew that they would do their very best and go, you know, out of their way to see that the script comes onto the screen as it should.
Mm-hmm.
So I had no hesitation after that in saying yes, and I'm happy that I said yes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it was a beautiful, lovely film. I mean, absolutely beautiful. Now, I know a little bit about you. You had an where you come from. Now, going to law school, which you were a scholar, a brilliant scholar at law school, how did you just drift away? Sab kuch chhod chhad ke acting mein aap kaise aa gaye?
You know, it was one of those happy accidents of life.
Okay.
And I belong to, and I actively belong to, now I just, you know, visit them very occasionally.
Uh-huh.
I belong to an organization called IPTA, Indian People's Theatre Association.
Okay.
So we were all doing amateur theatre then, helping around, doing backstage, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
One of our senior and very respected directors was Mr. M.S. Satyu.
Achcha.
He was making a film called Garm Hawa. He had very little money.
Okay.
And he wanted people who would give him all the dates that he wanted and charge him next to nothing.
Right.
So obviously he cast the net amongst friends and colleagues. He offered me a role.
Mm-hmm.
I thought the role was good. And more than that, I thought the film script was excellent.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I said yes.
Mm-hmm.
And Balraj Sahni Saab was the main protagonist.
Right.
And as we know, he did an absolutely brilliant job in the film.
Right.
The film turned out to be one of the most highly spoken of films,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
in Hindi cinema.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, I remember I was holidaying in the US and Canada.
Mm-hmm.
And I got a call one day from a very somber sounding, very proper accented gentleman who said, I am Satyajit Ray.
Right.
And I am making my first film.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like you to do a role. My first film in Hindi.
Right.
And I thought somebody is pulling my leg. I said, yeah, oh, thank you very much. I'm on a holiday in Canada and very nice of you to call. I put the phone
down. Right, right.
He must have understood that he doesn't believe that this is the Mr. Ray.
Right.
So he called back again. He said, no, I'm genuinely Mr. Satyajit Ray. I'm making a film called Shatranj Ke Khiladi.
Right. Give me
the details.
Exactly.
And then I was like very embarrassed and I apologized profusely and I said, Ray Saab, but I'm out of India for about 2 months.
Right.
So it's just my misfortune that you're shooting it now.
Mm-hmm.
They said, no, your portion I can do when you come back.
Right.
So I thought that was like God sent.
Oh.
So Mumbai mein kahawat hai ki gaate gaate gawai ho gaye. Tab karte karte actor ho gaye.
Actor ho gaye. Aur wo bhi mashhoor.
Ab wo to fit.
Aur wo bhi us kamyabi pe aap pahunche hain jo matlab I don't know, you're looked upon very highly. All throughout the world, especially Washingtonians, we look very highly upon you.
Indulgent and kind.
Now, tell me, Farooq Sheikh ji, aapka experience with Tumhari Amrita. Tell me your experience.
The play is originally written by an American author called A.R. Gurney.
Yes.
And Firoz Khan Saab read the play. He thought it was very uniquely formatted.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, I'd like to do this in Hindustani or in Urdu. So he spoke with Mr. Javed Siddiqui, a very celebrated writer.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, let's adapt this into, not translate it, let's adapt this into the Indian context, which Javed Saab did absolutely brilliantly. And then Firoz Saab called up Shabana Azmi Ji and said, I'd like to, you know, meet you and Farooq Sheikh and discuss this role. So Shabana called me and said, I've heard of a very nice script. Let's hear it out. So I said, sure. So we heard the script. We both thought it was fabulous. And we said, yes. But the catch was that it was to be a completely experimental presentation.
Achcha.
Two people sitting on their respective chairs at their tables and reading letters. No music, no change of costume, no movement, nothing whatsoever. So we thought it will be purely experimental. And we have what is called the Jennifer Kapoor Festival at Prithvi Theatres in Mumbai. Celebrated Jennifer Kapoor. And we thought we'll do it there, and it'll be like three or four shows, and we'll then wind it up because it's too experimental for people to like.
Right.
But the very first show took off fabulously.
Wow.
And the rest, as they say, is 21 years of history.
It's going on and on and on. Exactly. That's, I think, your last visit to DC was because of...
In that connection.
Exactly, yes, in that connection. Because I remember attending it, and you and Shabana Ji were on stage. And unfortunately, I couldn't get to interview you, but I did interview her. And it was, I mean, she had all flowers and beautiful words to say about acting with you. So, you know,
she
who doesn't?
Generous.
Tell me, stage actor, serial actor, movie actor, agar main aapse poochu, what do you prefer? One of the three, which of the above would you choose?
You know, there is, I believe, no real need for choosing just one.
Achcha.
If you have the opportunity to do all three, you should, whenever you feel like. But if in the completely abstract situation of having to pick only one, then I'd pick cinema.
Wow.
For the simple reason that cinema is more challenging for me as an actor because it, I mean, forbids me, or it's too formidable a medium for me to cheat in. I'll tell you why.
Okay.
If I'm doing theatre, then beyond the first row, or probably not even the first row, people can't catch really the expression in your eye.
That is so true.
And even more if you're sitting
in the back. That's right.
But in cinema, you can't cheat. The camera gets into your brain.
That's right.
Because a close-up would show your eye to be 5 feet.
That's right. That's right.
You can't cheat. So that is the greater challenge.
That's right.
And that is why in the completely hypothetical situation, I would say that I would go for cinema more than theatre or more than television. Although, of course, it's histrionics.
Of course. I mean, once an actor, always an actor. Yes. You know, aap wahan bhi kar sakte, yahan bhi, yahan bhi. But I kind of admire what you just said. Mr. Chashme Baddur, you are still known to be that iconic character in the movie. Tell me a little bit about your experience in that movie. And now that they have remade it with the, and I actually interviewed Mr. Ali Zafar last week.
Really?
Okay. Yes, and he said he saw you and the movie several times before he actually got to play the character. And I think he plays your character.
I
haven't seen it either. But when I interviewed him last week, he spoke very highly of you. Now, tell me your experience, and why did that movie catch fire all throughout the world?
I had done a film called Noori.
Yes, with
Poonam Dhillon.
Poonam, Hanji.
And for whatever reason, certainly.
And you were fabulous there.
We'll agree to disagree on
that. Okay, all right.
So, the film did very well at the box office. It was the biggest hit of that year.
That's right.
I think 79 or something like
that. That's right.
And after that, as happens with cinema, I got about 40 scripts which were good, bad, indifferent versions of Noori.
Okay.
So I thought, arey, ye toh bahut sar khapane wali baat
hai. Right, right.
It's very boring, so I didn't do any work for 2 years. Then one fine day, I got a call from a lady who said, I'm Sai Paranjpe.
Okay.
And I have a script I'd like you to hear. So I went over and I heard the script, very nice script, written from word one to the end.
Okay.
And that script was Chashme Baddur.
Of course.
And So he said, I'd like you to do this role. I said, sure. Uh-huh. And if the producer can agree to, you know, mutually agree acceptable terms,
right.
Sure. So I met the producer, we had a little back and forth, finally agreed. And we did Chashme Baddur. The reason why Chashme Baddur is today what many people call like a cult film.
Okay.
Is because the comedy of that kind had not been seen before.
I see.
This, you know, male bonding, three friends who live.
Yes.
And there is a girl that all three of them are vying for.
Right.
And things like that. But the magic of the film lies in Sai's script.
You know what? It's interesting you said that because last summer I had interviewed Deepti ji. Okay. And actually, do bar main interview kar chuki hu. And I asked her the same question. Maybe aap dono ek school ke padhe hue hain because she said the same thing,
but that
the magic lies in the script.
That is the fact of the matter. Sai film, we worked in two of Sai's films.
Okay.
Deepti ji and I. Chashme Baddur and then Katha.
Katha.
And Sai's film is more than 70% complete when she finishes writing the script. Because the rest of it is just translating that written word into the image on the screen. And she is so beautifully talented in terms of getting humor out of everyday situation. So, jo aam aadmi ki zindagi mein jo humor hota hai aur jo mizaj isko hum kehte hain wo hota hai, uske liye Sai ka koi jawab nahi. And that is really what makes Sai such a special filmmaker. And she did that. Before that, she had, before Chashme Baddur, not many people remember that. She did another brilliant film called Sparsh.
Oh,
no,
I didn't.
Nasiruddin Shah Saab and Shabana. Beautiful film. And very nice script. Magnificently performed by both the lead players. And then she did Chashme Baddur, then she did Katha.
Right.
Then she did, I think, one more film which I didn't get to see, which had Om Puri and Shabana and Nana Patekar and others. But after that, Sai hasn't been as active as we'd like her to be.
So, Farooq ji, am I correct in assuming that the success of the movie, even when it reaches the box office, is not necessarily the actor, the director, the producer, but it lies, the depth lies, the beauty lies in the script?
Essentially, the script is the spinal cord of a film.
Okay.
But there are films which are very successful at the box office which have a horrid script. But then the star image of the performer or performers,
commercial films,
carries it through because you know that that image of the megastar is so powerful that people want to see him or her
doing
whatever he or she is doing.
Absolutely.
But otherwise, and I think any kind of film that has to have a lasting value and has to become what one might call memorable,
right,
simply must have a good script. You can't do it otherwise. And if you have a good script, then you're more than halfway through. So people who have made all these extraordinary films, almost all of them have had fabulous scripts.
That's true. Now, you as an actor, or wo bhi mashhoor actor, is it true that you're choosing in your scripts before you say yay or nay to a movie? आप पढ़ते हैं देखते हैं स्क्रीन करते हैं इमेज फॉर्म करते हैं बिफोर यू से यस और नो
दैट इज ट्रू बिकॉज ऑफ द काइंड ऑफ बिगिनिंग्स दैट वी हैड विद सत्यु साहब एंड मुजफ्फर साहब
राइट
एंड रे साहब एंड अदर रीडिंग द स्क्रिप्ट फर्स्ट इज लाइक यू नो अ रिलीजियस ड्यूटी
ओके
यू डू इट फर्स्ट एंड देन इफ यू लाइक इट देन यू गो अहेड विद व्हाटएवर एल्स इज टू बी डन दैट मेक्स इट अ लिटिल डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू डू टू मच वर्क
राइट
आई थिंक दैट्स गुड फॉर यू एंड दैट्स वेरी गुड फॉर द ऑडियंस एज वेल
दैट्स ट्रू
बिकॉज़ दे आर स्पेयर्ड द ट्रिब्यूलेशन ऑफ सीइंग यू टू ऑफन
राइट
सो आई थिंक स्क्रिप्ट पढ़ना
बहुत जरूरी है ये इवेंट डीसी साहब 213 होने से पहले हमारे टेलीविजन शो पे आपके कमर्शियल्स रन होते थे
अच्छा
तो बहुत सारे वाशिंगटनियंस ने हमें कॉल करके एंड आई'd लाइक टू टेल शेयर दिस विद यू कहा कि अच्छा वो वही फारूक शेख है जो उमराव जान में थे हमने कहा हाँ जी वही है
मुजफ्फर अली साहब
वाले हाँ जी सो आई मीन जस्ट फॉर आवर वाशिंगटनियंस आप उनको दो लाइन बताइएगा योर एसोसिएशन हाउ यू फेल्ट acting with Rekha in that movie?
Oh, it was a very interesting experience. And then we did two more films together.
Yes.
And, you know, Rekha ji at that time was in the prime of her popularity.
Pinnacle.
Yeah.
Yes.
And she was also like amazingly presentable on screen. You could hardly find anybody who was that attractive.
That's right.
And with that kind of a histrionic range, very few people have a combination of that. So Rekhaji was like fabulously famous, and we had heard some pretty discouraging stories about how temperamental she can be and how she might walk off the set in a huff and things
like
that. So anyway, everybody was talking about that, but I thought she'll do her job, I'll do my job. Even if she walks off, she can't carry me off the set.
That's right.
I'm too heavy for that. So she'll walk off, and that's for Muzaffar Ali Saab to tackle.
Right.
But the truth of the matter turned out to be completely contrary to what we had heard. She was like the picture of cooperation and endurance with a smile. Because the Umrao Jaan schedule was a very trying schedule.
Right.
Lucknow and around Lucknow in the severe winter that UP has, and a lot of shooting being done in the night. The crowds that used to go completely berserk because Rekhaji was on the set.
That's right.
And it was literally like shots being fired.
Ye na bhuliyega, you are on the set.
No, humko koi puchta nahi. People were like going, you know, completely
bananas.
With Rekhaji. And if you didn't allow them to come and intrude onto the set, they'd fire shots and
things. Oh my God.
And there'd be huge police arrangements to
riot,
keep the crowds away. But she was like the picture of cooperation. I have the highest regard for her as, as a co-artist.
Jeena Isi ka naam. Uske baare mein batayega?
I had done a serial with NDTV.
Right.
Who produced Jeena Isi ka naam.
Yes.
It was called G Mantri Ji and G Pradhan Mantri Ji. Yes Minister and Yes Prime Minister. So they approached me with this script and they said, see, there is a show that we'd like to do where celebrities come onto the show and then we talk to them about their life and their beginnings and their you know, achievements, etc., etc. So I thought that was a good idea. And NDTV, as I said, was somebody I was familiar with, very sincere, conscientious, hardworking people. And I said, yeah, okay. And the first day that I went to shoot the episode, it used to be shot in Delhi in the beginning. They had come with a writer who had a huge script and about 23 questions or something like that. I was bold enough to suggest to the producer, who was a friend because I had done work with her. And I said, let's not keep a script at all. Let's just start talking and let's see where it goes.
Just ad lib.
And they were nice enough to agree to that. And the writer was very cross with me, I'm sure, because he lost out on whatever kind of wage he was going to get. But that is really what made Jeena that much more watchable.
Wow.
It was completely informal and spontaneous.
Wow.
And most of the people who came to the program, I think almost all of them, came with a completely open mind and open heart. Because they knew that they will go back from the episode looking taller and better and bigger than what they arrived. Because after all, they're achievers.
Of course.
That's why we call them.
Right.
And even though we pulled a leg or two whenever we wanted to, they took it in great spirit and it went beautifully.
That's lovely. In all your acting career, whether it's movies, serial, drama, theatre, is it fair to say what is your most favorite or one that touches your heart the most?
I would be lying if I named any one. So at my age, I think I should stop lying.
Upar wale bhi aapko maaf nahi karenge.
Haan, wo kahenge abhi aane ka time ho gaya. Abhi bhi jhoot bolna
baki hai. Nahi, wo baat nahi hai. I mean,
so
you're...
I'd be, you know, bluffing.
You enjoyed every one of them as
not
equal.
Not really everyone, because sometimes you read a script, you find it very nice. The director seems nice, producer seems okay. But in the making of it, something or the other goes wrong and then you feel, oh God, why did I do this? So that happens, but that has happened seldom.
Right.
So I've enjoyed almost all the work that I've been entrusted to do and which I've been fortunate enough to work with. And apart from myself, I've generally been happy with the product.
Oh, that's nice. And now, seedhiyon ke is mukam pe aap pahunch aaye hain. Ab yahan se aage aapka kya irada hai? Where do you see yourself?
Kam buri acting karne ka irada.
Really?
Ki ab tak jitni karta hoon usse thodi kam buri karo. जहाँ जहाँ गलती हो रही है उसको थोड़ा सा सुधारने की कोशिश करूँ और ऑडियंस के साथ जो है थोड़ी सी बेइंसाफी कम होनी चाहिए.
Because
when you watch yourself, you're always full of dismay that अरे ये क्यों किया और ऐसे.
Self critique.
All actors are like that.
Right. Any ideas or thoughts of teaching the profession to others?
Oh God.
कभी भी नहीं.
I mean, the profession has lots of problems. Let me not add another huge one.
So उससे दूर रहने का है.
जी अब तो सीखने के दिन चल रहे हैं तो बढ़ाने के दिन कब आएंगे?
Okay. If you were not acting, what do you see yourself doing today?
I would have been probably a very unhappy lawyer because I didn't want to do a job. I didn't want to do anything that.
Why? Because like they say, lawyers are liars. That's why.
I'm a liar, but I'm not a good liar.
Okay, that means you wouldn't have made a good lawyer. Let me tell you that.
I would have made an unhappy lawyer. Unhappy lawyer. Mm-hmm. Because there is a limit to how much you can lie.
That's right.
And then go and sleep peacefully. So I would have made an unhappy lawyer.
That's true. Now tell me, what is one negative thing that you see in life today?
In general or in my profession?
No, in your profession.
I think the budgets have become more important than the film itself. You should not begin with the bottom line of your balance sheet.
Mm.
You should begin with what you're trying to make.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're putting your reputation on the line.
That's right.
And if you start with that, it's like, you know, trying to construct a figure where you begin from the tail.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. By the time you reach the head, you've lost all your energy and inspiration and the head is distorted and gone. And the tail has withered away in any case.
That's true.
If you begin from the head, I think you would do well and the tail would find a proper place for itself.
That's very true.
But that is unfortunate. But that is true. I mean, this is a legacy that we have inherited from the good old US of A.
That's right.
Hollywood has taught us this, that make mega budget entertainers, they don't have to make sense. They just have to make noise.
That's
and
right.
Whilst you're in the auditorium, enjoy the noise and come out and forget what you see.
You know what? I really like you. Because you know what? Everybody would agree with everything you just said today. No, really, honest to God, because that's how we cinema goers feel. चलो ऐश आराम करेंगे बाय सिटी
देख लो और बाहर आ जाओ अपना
घर जाओ. Exactly.
It's like, you know, having a packet of popcorn.
That's
you
right.
You don't really go for it for the nutrition or the lasting value.
That's
you
right.
You just go that till it's in your mouth, it's a little good taste and it keeps you busy. Your heart chalta rehta till you finish.
That's right. Absolutely, perfectly. Tell us a little bit about your personal life, your family life.
Mm-hmm. I am married.
Of course.
Since 79, so whatever number of years that is. And I have two grown-up daughters,
mm-hmm.
very charming ladies who are full of their criticism of their father. And who keep always telling me how I'm completely wrong about this, that or the other.
At least somebody tells you, right?
Oh, yes.
Oh, okay.
Have you forgotten my wife? I mean, I ask your husband this.
We always tell our husbands, ye kyun kiya?
Jee.
Ye kaise hua? Ye kyun nahi kiya?
That's part of the marriage contract.
Absolutely.
And P.S. No. I'll keep telling you, ye kyun kiya?
Absolutely.
So that's part of the contract. So otherwise, I'm like quite happy.
What do your daughters do? Anyone did? Nobody wanted to go into acting like you?
Oh, they see far more movies than I do, but they are not interested in participating. One of them is part of a social activity group, which works for slum children.
Achcha.
The other one has a travel boutique of her own.
Achcha.
Which she's very fond of.
Both back in India?
Back in India.
Achcha.
And my wife has the very onerous task of taking care of three completely demanding individuals and seeing to it. I think housewives are magical figures.
Of course.
And they are really the hub of human society.
Of course.
And we pay far too little, you know, attention to
it's
them.
It's us
them far
that make
credit.
You all what you are
absolutely
today.
True. Absolutely.
Thank you, sir. Absolutely. I really appreciate it.
Every housewife, wherever she is. She's a homemaker, actually.
That's right.
A homemaker.
That's right.
And home is where society is reflected.
Absolutely.
So I'm full marks to them.
Ah, beautiful. Before I let you off the camera, I have just one request for all our Washington viewers. यदि मैं आपसे फरमाइश करूं कि आपने इतने मतलब ज़िंदगी में इतने acting करें, इतने dialogues करें, एक line हमारे दर्शकों को आप सुनाए जो that's close to your heart, would it be fair?
I wouldn't know which one. You tell me which one, I'll try and remember.
That I will not do.
So then we'll have to wait for the next
is it, it doesn't
and I'll memorize the line and come.
You're so bad. No, I mean, you were fabulous in Listen to Maya as well.
Wow.
You were, I mean, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, I'd see that movie over and over again. It doesn't matter, you can even recite a line from that.
I think there's one scene, remember, in which I said that maine zahir to nahi kiya, but I love you, Leela, and I love Amaya too. So So that was a nice line.
I'm smart because I knew he would say that. I swear to God, I knew you would say that. I swear.
I knew you're very smart, which is why I agreed to the interview.
Any loving messages to all your fans out there? There's the camera.
I mean, if there are any.
Oh, there are millions.
Watch good cinema. Encourage good cinema. And I personally believe, and this is straight from the heart, that festivals like this are an act of service. Because anything or anybody who raises your level of aesthetics is doing you a genuine act of service. So patronize them. And I don't know whether the organizers have to go chasing the sponsors or it's the sponsors who willingly come and participate. But if they are going chasing the sponsors, then please, you chase them because they are doing you service. They are doing you a really good deed. So don't allow them to be distracted by having to chase you, apart from, you know, arranging so many things and putting up with people like me who till the last moment can't decide whether they're coming or they're not coming. the organizers are going tearing their hair with me deciding ki main aa sakunga ya nahi aa sakunga.
Bade bade logo ke bade bade kaam hote hain.
Nahi, bade bade logo ke nahi. Par aap meri size ka zikr please mat kijiye. एक्चुअली हुआ ये था कि मैं श्रीनगर में शूटिंग कर रहा था.
अच्छा अच्छा.
और वहाँ वो यूनिट जो है बेचारा पागल हुआ जा रहा था क्योंकि इट वॉज रेनिंग. सो दे कुड नॉट पैक अप एन 80% यूनिट एंड से कि अच्छा ठीक है आप फेस्टिवल में हो आइए हम लोग मुंबई चले जाते हैं फिर आएंगे. इट वॉज नॉट पॉसिबल. सो टिल द वेरी लास्ट मोमेंट वी वर ऑन टेंटर हुक्स वेदर आई विल बी एबल टू मेक इट और नॉट. बट आई एम सो ग्लैड आई डिड मेक इट एंड आई एम एब्सोल्युटली डिलाइटेड विद व्हाट द फेस्टिवल ऑर्गेनाइजर्स हैव डन. Please go out and see the film, see this kind of cinema, patronize it and help them out because they are helping you out.
There you go, the star of all stars, Mr. Farooq Sheikh, in any and every cinema, television, serial, stage, actor, theatre, very humble personality here in the Washington metro area. Bahut bahut shukriya.
Bahut ada, bahut shukriya.
Bahut bahut shukriya. Good luck.
Thank you.
Aapke future plans and projects may keep the Washingtons posted and also न्यूयॉर्क न्यूयॉर्क तक आके ना चला जाइएगा क्योंकि यहाँ भी प्यार है.
यहाँ तो बहुत सारा प्यार है.
फिर
बिगिंस फ्रॉम द व्हाइट हाउस.
फिर
यू हैव टू फैबुलस पीपल इन द व्हाइट हाउस.
दैट्स राइट. दैट्स राइट.
मिस्टर ओबामा एंड मिसेस ओबामा.
दैट्स राइट. दैट्स राइट.
आई एडमायर देम ग्रेटली.
सो डोंट जस्ट कम टू न्यूयॉर्क एंड पुट अ पीरियड.
बट देन मिस्टर एंड मिसेस ओबामा हैव टू इनवाइट.
दे हैव टू इनवाइट यू. कल मैं चिट्ठी लिखती हूं. ऑलराइट सर.
कल के संडे में ईमेल.
एब्सोल्युटली विल. थैंक यू सो मच.
ग्रेट प्लेजर. ऑल द बेस्ट यू.
थैंक यू सर.
ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू टू. आदाब, मैं हूं फारूक शेख, वाशिंगटन डीसी नेशन के कैपिटल में, और आप देख रहे हैं चित्रमाला.